Hi, everybody. I don't know how much battery I have on my phone, so we'll just make this really quick. But, hi, this is my 9 months. Hello, it's Damien. How are you? Let's see, there's been a lot of stress lately, so sorry about the pauses and the delays and all the other nonsense going on right now. I'm trying to drive home. It is officially my 9 months mark, so that's very, very exciting. That's why I'm doing this. It's been pretty crazy for the last month or so, but now that we're in October, I'm pretty excited. Usually business goes up during October, and hopefully that stays the same this year. Who knows? Anyway, things about my transition, if there are really very many that are happening. More hair, of course. Beard is coming in a little bit thicker. I just shaved a couple days ago, so it's not very strong right now, obviously. But I've got quite a bit of facial hair going on nowadays, so that's cool. Except the only problem with that is I'm getting a lot of ingrown hairs now, which I didn't realize I was prone to. So, it's been kind of hard to keep up on my face. What are you whining about? We're almost home. We're like 3 minutes from home. But, once I shave, that tends to go away. So as long as I don't let my hairs grow out like super, super long, I don't get these massive sores on my face from ingrown hairs. Which, you know, I guess if that's how it is, that's how it is. Anyway, sorry, I got a phone call and I had to hang up for a second. So, not much else happening as far as that goes. My voice is finally kind of settling in. It took about 8 months, but my voice is finally starting to settle and into what I think it's probably going to remain as, which is super awesome, because I like how it sounds. It still sounds like me, but it sounds deeper. But anyway, I've been having a lot of anxiety issues lately because of not just money, but just where we live, and we kind of have a shitty neighbor situation happening right now where somebody keeps complaining about us, and even though we are totally not in the wrong on anything that we're doing, I just have this feeling that somebody doesn't like our family for some reason, or doesn't like our daughter because she goes outside and she plays with a friend all the time. So she's a little loud, but you know, that's she's a kid. That's what happens. And anyway, so we got a complaint a couple days ago, apparently, and management was like, hey, you guys need to come in at 3 o'clock on Wednesday for this appointment with this other family that's also basically in trouble for unattended children, was what they said, which is complete bullshit. And I apologize for my use of language in this video, but I don't care. because we check on our kid, you know, every half hour, and the only thing that they could choose to complain about was that at one point our daughter decided to leave some toys outside overnight. And in the morning, early morning, I brought them back in because I didn't realize they were outside. I brought them all in. It was like 4 a.m. in the morning. I brought them all in. But, okay. And if it's a matter of leaving trash out there, they always pick up. I never see their trash left over anymore. So, I mean, I don't know. It feels like it was an excuse to attack us and the other family with their daughter, because the two kids are loud outside during the daytime when they're allowed to be loud outside. But since they can't complain about it at nighttime because the kids aren't playing at night, they choose to complain about it during the day. And it just doesn't make any sense to me. So anyway, both my wife and I have been very annoyed about it. And I've actually been looking for other places around the area to move to, because I am just so sick of the people that we live around being complete assholes. And I mean, like, I don't know, they were kind of like that in Idaho too, but the thing is, like, they don't In Idaho, it was more of if there's a complaint, it's only if it's like a really, really big one. And that was at our... What are you doing, Taffy? That was at our last apartment complex that we were in. And of course, management and people are all going to be different. But it's just like, I don't know. In Oregon, it's so weird. You've got super, super friendly people. Super, super friendly people. They, you know, yank off the shirt off their backs and give it to you if you really needed it. And then you have the complete, absolute, worst, rotten assholes on the face of the earth. Like, completely black and white here. There's no in-between. There aren't any indifferent people. It's either the person is super, super nice, or they're complete dickwads. And, I don't know, it's like a 50-50 anytime I go outside because I'm about to run into a complete dickwad, or I'm about to run into somebody who I'm like, hey! And it's just, I don't know, it's weird, and it's very bipolar, and it makes me very uncomfortable. So, I don't know what we'll do there. Anyway, I only have a couple of minutes left, but I wanted to say, ideally, we'll stay living here and everything will work out okay, because this is the cheapest apartment that we could possibly find right now on the market. So anyway, yeah, so also I wanted to say, look, my hairline is changing. Check that out. Isn't that cool? So anyway, I'll cut this off now because Taffy is clearly a little antsy and wants to get out of the car, and I'm ready to go inside and try and deal with the stress until... this evening when I can finally relax. So wish me luck, and I love you guys, and thank you for all of your support. I can't think of anything else to say right now because I've got too many crap things on my mind. So I'll get back to you guys at a later date. Thank you again, and talk to you soon.